You know, after leaving Vice, a lot of bloggers have trouble reacclimating into normal society.
I see a victim. It's another victim.
So this is a trailer.
Not enough women.
Well, let's just watch it first. So it's my job as a therapist to help them get in touch with the person they once were.
Kind of interesting, the whole place is all white.
Okay, you know what? Let's sit you back down. Let's get you back down.
I keep having this recurring nightmare where they need my help, but I can't help them without my Vice job.
Who needs your help, Daniel?
The Latinxes. Without blogging, I lost my sense of purpose.
You don't work there anymore.
I'm on a deadline.
I see a white devil, an appropriator.
This is your mother.
Wow, I really hope that guy makes it. It's not looking good for him. Welcome back, beautiful and amazing human beings. This is Luke Dowski of WeAreChange.org. That intro video was just a short excerpt of the great comedy of Ryan Long. His YouTube video will be down in the description. Definitely go check him out and give him a follow. He's doing incredible work right now that, in my opinion, is needed more than ever. But in this video, we are going to be getting into some complex issues regarding the Conholio sickness jab, as well as the current updates about the Orwellian police state that we live in. But before that, aliens! Yes, they're right here on this screen, as of course we have a bombshell revelation from the former head of Israel's space program that just came out moments ago. And according to the JewishPress.com, said that aliens are here, they are real, and they, quote, asked not to be revealed because, quote, humanity is not ready for them. Yes, Professor Haim Eshed, who served as the head guy for Israel's space program from 1981 to 2010, who also received the Israeli Security Award 3 times, and now people are thinking that he literally lost his marbles because he recently said, quote, the UFOs have asked not to publish that they are here. Humanity is not ready yet. Trump was on the verge of revealing, but the aliens in the Galactic Federations are saying, wait, let people calm down first. They don't want to start mass hysteria. They want to first make us sane and understanding. Now, this is on the heels of just a few days ago, on October 11th of this year, Trump saying that he's going to take a, quote, good look and a strong look at whether aliens exist or not. We have seen similar epithets talked about by previous presidents like Barack Obama and Bill Clinton, usually on TV talk show hosts with many people laughing. But it is important to acknowledge here that the Pentagon does have a new task force that is in charge of studying UFOs. They previously had other task force that were classified and no one knew about them. You know, the government knowingly lied to you, told you that such a task force didn't exist. Meanwhile, it did. But oddly, when asked about this new UFO Pentagon task force, Donald Trump then went on and talked about the military prowess of the United States, which some people have likened to threatening aliens with military force. With just how absolutely crazy 2020 has been going, it could be an actual probability that this might actually happen. But according to the former head of Israel's space program, the aliens, quote, want to first make sure that humans are sane and understanding before they reveal themselves. And with the way that things are going, I definitely expect them to be waiting a very long time, since, of course, humanity is the opposite of sane and understanding now, especially with all the latest tribalistic fights that have been happening, all because of insane party politics. So yeah, I think those aliens are in for a situation that's going to be a long haul here. Along, of course, with the censorship of free speech and independent media that we see on the internet, it's going to take a while for humanity to realize the trap that they are in, that, of course, a few elites benefit from. Now, Professor Eshed, the Israeli space program former head, also went on and said, quote, they, referring to the aliens, have been waiting for humanity to evolve and reach a stage where we will generally understand what space and spaceships are. There's an agreement between the U.S. government and the aliens. They signed a contract with us to do experiments here. They, too, are researching and trying to understand the whole fabric of the universe, and they want us as helpers. There's an underground base in the depths of Mars where their representatives are, and also our American astronauts. He goes on and says, quote, if I had come up with that, I'm saying today, 5 years ago, I would have been hospitalized. Whether I've gone with this in academia, they've said the man has lost his mind. Today, they're already talking differently. I have nothing to lose. I received my degrees and awards. I am respected in universities abroad where the trend is also changing. And Professor Ishhead does make a very valiant point, since, of course, recently we have seen major revelations by the U.S. government and also the U.S. military not only acknowledging that there are unidentified flying objects that the U.S. military has had experiences with, but also releasing the video footage of it. Like the one that you're watching right now that is an object that is literally defying the laws and science of physics. This is real, and it would be very naive for us to believe that we are the only living creatures inside such a vast space. Now, I know some people are going to be making some religious arguments, but it is important to point out that many theorists have brought out the proposal that a lot of this could be advanced military technology, a part of a psyop, like akin to Project Bluebeam, which is a very interesting theory to ponder here while we're looking at all of this, to be quite honest with you. Now, it's also important to note here that Donald Trump's strong and good look at the UFOs still hasn't been publicly acknowledged for almost 2 months now, and he looks like he's going to be leaving office soon, so I hope he learns to speak up, because I definitely do believe humanity does deserve to know the truth. Whether Professor Ishhead is saying it or he's a part of some larger psyop, I think it is definitely clear that we definitely need more research, openness, and understanding when it comes to this very complex issue, which we could only get through an honest, rational conversation, which we definitely need more of. Also, we have to understand, this is on the backdrop of the United States literally creating another branch of the U.S. military called the Space Force. So yeah, could be a coinky dick there, but I truly do believe that we're going towards another kind of understanding, another kind of comprehension that's going to be totally different than it is right now, whether it's regarding UFOs or just the way civilization is. I do think major changes are coming to a head. Now, it's also important to note that there's also other allegations by this professor about aliens stopping the nuclear apocalypse, which could potentially explain why there hasn't been one with government being so incompetent. Yeah, if you look at the DMV and understand that these are the same type of people that have nuclear weapons, you should be absolutely terrified. But now that there's potentially maybe aliens stopping nuclear warfare, that's a little bit more of a understanding that I'm willing to accept, since, of course, human history is filled with governments sacrificing their citizens, killing each other, all for silly conquest and gains that have dominated world history. So yeah, I leave this question next to you. What do you think? Do you think that this is a psyop akin to Project Bluebeam? And coming very soon, do you think this is legitimate? There's a lot of disinformation and, in my opinion, psyops within the UFO community, which prevents an honest dialogue, but I truly do hope to have one down in the description below. In the meantime, I still definitely recommend people prepare as much as they can, but at the same time, enjoy themselves in the holiday spirit as much as they can. Time is precious. Take advantage of it and make sure you're spending it with your friends, family members, and of course, you're staying away from the corporate brainwashing mainstream media that is filled with disinformation and propaganda, like CNN, that is literally doing advertisement campaigns for Saudi Arabia. Yes, CNN International is advocating for tourism to Saudi Arabia, rewriting and regurgitating PR puff pieces by the Saudi Empire that literally is known for its human rights violations. Now, I do have to warn you, if you are a part of the LGBTQ radicalized feminist, or is it third wave feminism now? I don't know. If you're one of these people and you color your armpit hair, I would, not recommend maybe visiting Saudi Arabia, because you are going to have a very bad time, since they literally throw off gays off of roofs. But yeah, CNN says go right on and visit them. since, of course, you know, they're the progressive news network of the resistance. And while CNN gets promoted by YouTube, pushed in the algorithm, every search result regarding news shows up with them first. Meanwhile, with this channel, the exact opposite of that happens. We here need to rely on your support to survive, since, of course, we are fully demonetized. And now YouTube has even decided to put ads on this video and our previous videos that, of course, they don't share any of the revenue from, like they do with all the other YouTube program partners. So your support is more crucial than ever, and you could very easily do that on wearechange.org/donate. There are very easy ways to donate. Just $5 a month means the world to us, and this is the main way that we consistently are able to operate. And it truly, if it wasn't for you, if it wasn't you helping, I wouldn't be here. I don't make a lot off of this. I make enough to survive, and I am truly, absolutely grateful for that. Just $5 a month. Or you could use cryptocurrencies, physical mail, or even you could support us without spending a single dime by checking out some of the alternative platforms that reward you and me for using them. So yeah, wearechange.org/donate is the website, and your support is greatly appreciated. Now, CNN is not the only hypocritical bastion of fake news. It's predominating our world right now, as of course we just utterly see so much hypocrisy and people exploiting the Canholio sickness tragedy in order to benefit off of it politically. If you want to reopen schools, that's racist. If you want to close schools, that's racist too. The hypocrisy just continues to go on, as of course the mainstream media right now is portraying that there's going to be an absolute genocidal bloodbath for Christmas, as of course many of the pundits for their news organizations, quote, news organizations, don't follow any of the safety protocols themselves as they lecture you on how you need to do this. Science usually doesn't matter to a lot of these individuals, like the current example that you have on screen right now of hospitals in Los Angeles showing that usually they are running at a 90% occupancy rate, and that usually rises to 98% during flu season. Right now, it is important to note that they are at an 85% occupancy see when they are usually at a 90. So there's less people in the hospitals than there usually is. Now, this is just one example. It doesn't mean that this is the baseline happening all throughout the United States. But gathering such data, I believe, is very important. And I think we definitely need more research and more of an honest conversation when it comes to exactly what's happening when it comes to the Canholio sickness. As, of course, the mainstream media, some government officials are warning that the dark winter is, of course, approaching, as Fauci has grabbed onto some of the lexicon and is heeding the warnings about Christmas. All of this as more states go on lockdown, all according to the data from flip-flopping government agencies that haven't been consistent once throughout all of this, that have literally told you to do one thing, a week later tell you to do the completely opposite of that. The CDC that now have put that they are, quote, credible in their Twitter bio. And as U.S. Representative Thomas Massie says, if a government agency has to put that they're credible in its Twitter bio, it's probably not. And it hasn't been for the majority of Americans that have been absolutely dumbfounded with how flip-flopping and hypocritical they can be. And if it's not the CDC, it's usually Bill Gates, a man with man boob, also a big friend of Jeffrey Epstein, that lost a major monopoly court case with many individuals calling him an absolute greedy psychopath. I didn't say it. Other people are using those words to describe him. And of course, his career, which has made him one of the richest people in the world. Now, I don't know about you, but some of these lockdowns are a little inconsistent, especially when it comes to their logic. A lot of them are defying science, and some would say the lockdowns are, quote, abusive themselves. And I think that's something to really consider here, as of course, more cities, more jurisdictions, more counties all throughout the United States are being locked down more and more, as of course the lockdowns didn't work at first, but now somehow they will. And I'm sorry, but I think we should actually, you know, look at some of the real science here. I think we should actually consider what we're doing, since of course the damages that are being caused by the alleged cure for this sickness are causing a lot more death, human suffering than the sickness. I think it's fair to argue that already, but that is just my opinion. If you think I am wrong, in any way or in any instance, please let me know down in the comment section below. I usually try to answer comments within the first hour that a video is out. I'm not always perfect, but I do my best. I absolutely love the absolute, real, authentic, independent fact checkers out there that are able to provide me information that I could research and look into, since, of course, this is my full-time job, and I wouldn't have this job if it wasn't for you watching and sharing this video. Literally, just clicking that URL given to a random person, whoever it may be, makes the biggest difference. And because you guys still do that, I am here, and this is why I love you guys. Stay tuned for more here on WeAreChange.org.